Gastritis and peptic ulcers are two conditions affecting the stomach. In this video, we will identify the causes and symptoms of both gastritis and ulcers, as well as discuss the nutritional implications of these conditions. Gastritis includes inflammation of the stomach lining that is primarily caused by either the bacteria H. pylori or using non-steroidal anti-inflammatory medications. Less often, this inflammatory condition is related to viral or parasitic infections, chemical substances, or internal physical problems. Age also plays a role. The stomach and its function atrophies with advancing age, leading to a type of gastritis known as atrophic gastritis. Notice gastritis is rarely associated with food or lifestyle, with the exception of alcohol. That means nutrition therapy will not be a cure, but only used to relieve symptoms. Symptoms of gastritis include abdominal pain, nausea, vomiting, and occasionally belching, bloating, loss of appetite, and indigestion. Another condition affecting the stomach is ulceration of the stomach lining. Gastric ulcers include a break in the mucosa, resulting in a hole in the lining of the stomach. It causes pain, poor food intakes related to that pain, and feeling of fullness, heartburn, and bleeding that results in red or black bloody stool. As much as 50 to 70% of gastric ulcers are caused by H. pylori, which is a bacteria that lives in the mucosal lining of the stomach. The next most common cause is chronic use of non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs such as aspirin or ibuprofen. Like gastritis, there is little nutritional causes for ulcers. However, both do have some nutrition complications. And anytime the stomach is affected, there are similar nutritional implications. Whether gastritis or ulcers, one of our main concerns is anemia due to the losses of vitamin B12 and iron. Recall that the stomach is where vitamin B12 is released from food and where intrinsic factor that is required for B12 absorption is secreted. It is also where iron is reduced so it can be absorbed more easily. When we have complications with the stomach, these two nutrients are likely not absorbed, resulting in deficiencies and anemia. As you look at the causes and consequences of gastritis and ulcers, you should be thinking about how this will translate to diet and lifestyle modifications to treat it.